PayPal has this like, it's called like the payment hub, and it's for like, I guess it's for merchants, and it's, I don't know exactly what it does, but they've integrated it into that system, and so any merchant that uses PayPal Pay Hub can accept Bitcoin.
Gotcha. I think it's only for digital goods, like only for, music files, like
Okay.
digital video games and stuff like that. Seems like PayPal's is keeping to their word pretty much when they said that like the Braintree thing was their first foray into Bitcoin, and now
Yeah.
this comes out like within 2 weeks, and so they're moving pretty quickly. I think there's a good chance that we can see them actually integrate Bitcoin within, PayPal itself. My previous estimate was within like maybe a year, but with how quickly they're moving, we could see it within a few months maybe. That'd be crazy.
What exactly, like, I've never used PayPal, so like, what exactly would you send money to PayPal for? Like, don't they make all their money from like transaction fees?
Yeah, that's one way. They probably have other sources of revenue as well.
Like, what could you actually buy from PayPal Bitcoin if they, accepted it themselves and not just integrated it in their payment hub?
Oh, I gotcha. Yeah, like, well, if they accepted Bitcoin themselves, then that would mean that every place that already accepts PayPal payments would then accept Bitcoin through PayPal. So that would mean that you would be able to buy stuff on eBay, for instance, with Bitcoin,
Okay.
which, hasn't happened yet. And the way that some, news outlets cover these PayPal stories, they make it seem almost that PayPal itself is accepting Bitcoin, and it's not. It's that might be in the pipeline, but it's not happening yet.
Yeah. Still don't know exactly what this payment hub is. But you're right. It's digital content with PayPal. They can use PayPal to buy digital content with their phone, credit card, or other popular payment types, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, it seems like any place that that allows you to place a charge on like your phone bill, I mean, that's basically having the phone company act as a payment processor. Then the phone company pays the merchant. Like if a
Yeah.
merchant already agreed to that, there's literally no reason why they wouldn't also accept Bitcoin. Bitcoin is, I imagine, way better than that as than going through the phone company.
Yeah, and like, as a direct result, the price went up of Bitcoin went up to 450. So, that's pretty cool.
Oh, from the PayPal thing?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think so. I don't think that was what caused it. Why would that cause it, but then the other PayPal thing didn't cause it 2 weeks ago? Or any of the
Well,
other crazy positive news?
because people have been anticipating PayPal for a very long time. Braintree is like nobody. Like, there's not, like, nobody even knows what Braintree is.
Right.
After, like, ever since Overstock accepted Bitcoin, pretty much, people have been, like, waiting for PayPal to accept Bitcoin. So, once they made this announcement that, they were like kind of halfway accepting Bitcoin with their through their payments hub, they got people really excited. Like, the story was on the top of the Bitcoin subreddit for like 3 days.
Yes. Yes.
So
But there's a
yeah.
lot of stuff that's on top of the Bitcoin subreddit for multiple days at a time, and they don't mean crap, you know? Like they'll vote up memes and pictures of Coke bottles with the word Satoshi on it, you know?
The last thing I saw on top of the Bitcoin subreddit that was up there for more than a day was that thing about Apple Pay, and that's because the Fapping was like still going
Oh
on.
yeah. The Jennifer Lawrence meme thingy.
But no, it happened like the price went up, like started going up literally like an hour after the news. I got reported on. So, that's generally how long it takes for the price to react to news, because it takes a little while for it to circulate throughout the community. And
So you're
yeah,
saying
it.
that maybe someone heard that news and they're like, well, now that I can pay for my digital content in Bitcoin, I might as well invest thousands of dollars into Bitcoin.
Well, I mean, it's the same reason why Bitcoin shot up $40 when Dish started accepting. People are watching it and they're skeptical about it, and they're like, "Well, I just need this one thing that makes it seem really legitimate to me, and then I'll put some money into it." And that hap and and then it happens, and they're like, "Well, let me put some money into it, just because, oh, PayPal accepts it. PayPal is a very legitimate business, so maybe Bitcoin might go somewhere." It's the price. When merchants or when businesses accept Bitcoin and the price goes up, it's not because people now have a new place to spend their Bitcoin. It's because potential investors who are skeptical have become convinced enough of its legitimacy to put some money into it.
Gotcha. Okay. So that was kind of like the straw that broke the camel's back of this particular investor who's like, okay, that pushed me over the edge. I'll invest now.
Yeah, because Bitcoin community has been talking about PayPal, at least since I started, hanging around, and I'm sure, before then. So this is like really, hyped up news. It was like people were anticipating this for a long time. So,
Okay.
and when I saw that it went up, I was like, this is merchant adoption, so there's not really like any solid reason for the price to go up because of that. So it'll be back to 400 within a week, and it's back at 400.
Yeah,
So
because we still have that overall selling pressure that we talked about last week.